Hello everyone, this is Vion, the world is one news, and we are live in New Delhi, India. Welcome to Vion, world is one news. So as people are about to join us, can you see what we are looking at here? What does it look like? It's a painting, a drawing. Can you call it a wall art, street design, street art? It's all the same, various names. So today we'll be exploring the street art culture in New Delhi. Look at some of them. Oh, we have a Superman teasing the Hulk here. Have any of you guys ever wondered about street art in India, street art in New Delhi? We are live from New Delhi. What kind of... Look at the detailing at with which they've done this. And these are artists who have created expressions on Delhi's walls. Delhi's bare walls. And we'd like you to meet a few of them today. Look at that. So let's say hi to Sultan. Hi, Sultan.
Hi.
And Shikha.
Hi.
So Shikha and Sultan will be telling us a lot about their project of street art in Delhi called Wall D.
Yeah.
So guys, what is Wall D all about?
Wall D was actually I made my high school friends meet my college friends, then we decided to do something together, and that's actually we started with this wall. I made this on my sister's birthday, so I invited my friends to work on it. Her name is Iman.
Okay.
So this is how we started this whole situation.
Okay.
So.
And how many years ago was this?
We started in July 2013. So it's been 3 years almost.
Okay. And so from a birthday party, you took it forward to painting the streets of Delhi?
Yeah.
Cafes, restaurants.
Okay.
Hostels.
Okay.
We didn't realize we would go this far. So it started as we thought it's fun. So now it's our profession. So we like to keep it that way.
Okay.
Like things we do, what makes us happy. So what else do I want? Right?
So are you guys expressionist artists? Like do you draw out of memory, or you are learned, you are skilled? Can you tell our viewers who are joining us?
Yeah, we actually got graduated from Amity.
Okay.
A couple of years back.
So yes, we have a degree.
Right. So you guys are from Amity University in New Delhi. Okay.
Actually, I'm also a musician and she is a dancer. So
oh.
I would say we like to express a lot. So
guys,
through art.
These guys are really multi-talented here.
Thank you.
Art, dance, music, everything.
Thank you.
And how do you take this expression out of your homes, or how do you express on walls?
So we've been traveling a lot with our teams. We try to get as much as... it's quite necessary to get some commercial projects to earn some bread and butter. So that's what we are doing right now. So we got a project from Dainik Jagran as well. So we'll be working on that. And they're taking this whole metro station called Vaishali, and it'll be called as Dainik Jagran Vaishali. So it's quite a huge break for us.
So you'll be painting a metro station?
The whole metro station.
And tell us more about the story behind the name Baldi. Why Valdi?
Valdi, so there's a funny story. So we decided to jumble up the words of Walt Disney. So we made that. So we actually jumbled it up with Walt Design. So at a glance, you can't figure it out like it's Walt Design, but it's actually it is.
That became your logo.
So we decided to shorten our name. So we decided to keep this much part, Waldy. So D, there's no such like meaning behind D. So we call design, sometimes we call Delhi. So we are based from, based out in Delhi. So that's the whole story.
Okay,
nothing much
to say
about it.
That's how we started. And did you guys start together or you joined later?
So I started with Regmi. Can I have Regmi?
Oh hi, so we're going to be joined by a few more people. It's a bunch of art graduates here today.
Hi. So he's my high school friend, she's my college friend. So it's more like a family now, not just some profession.
Tell us a bit about you joining the world of street art.
Basically it was this piece of art. We started with this because his sister's birthday was there, and then we decided to make that. And that's how we started. First it was fun, then we got to know about some project, and then we got together.
Okay, so we have a viewer from Brazil. Hi there, hi back to you. Would you like to ask us any questions? We are covering live street art in New Delhi. How is street art in Brazil? If you have any comments, do write to us. So, do you think it's any different? I mean, you must have seen the street art or graffiti done in the Western countries, especially America or all over European countries. Do you think there's a difference in the way we do it in India?
No. Nowadays, Indians are quite getting into the street art world. So, there's a festival which is happening every year called Street Art Delhi.
Oh.
So we invite a lot of people from all around the world for the festival. So you can see like every 100 meter you can see an artwork in Delhi. So it's quite,
it's building up,
becoming a trend now. So yes, it's quite nice.
So there's a festival, when does it happen?
There's an organization called Street Art Delhi. You'll have to check it out, like their webpage, so to keep you updated.
And how do you guys participate in it? Do you participate every year? Or?
You have to register on it. So
is it only for expert artists?
No,
or
anyone
from the world.
Anyone,
can
join.
Okay, everybody, anyone and everybody can join it.
Yeah.
And what is the main concept that you paint? We've seen your wall art is all about superheroes. So we saw a Spider-Man, we saw a Hulk. I don't know the one behind this. Can you tell me?
That's a conceptual art of Thor.
Okay.
So actually the artworks you're seeing is quite old. So
that's how we started, like for fun.
It's been 3 years, so we selected our favorite superheroes to create, and then we created that.
Brilliant. So whose superhero is that?
I painted this one. It's a conceptual art of Thor from Marvel Universe. So.
Okay. So do you always paint, like what is your thought behind the street art that you do? And is it different from your commercial projects that you are currently getting to work on?
There's always a message behind in street art. Mm-hmm. So commercial is client-based.
So what's better, commercial or like free spirit?
Free spirit of thought anytime.
So has any one come to you and said, oh, you know, I have a wall, this is my wall, just go crazy, paint on it?
In Udaipur, it happened. Like, we were not bound to stuff, I guess.
Okay. Yeah. Please tell us more about your street art in Udaipur.
So, it's a hostel. Mm-hmm. It's called Bunkyard.
Okay.
So, he just gave us, like, freedom out. And we were like, what to create now?
Okay.
So we painted, it's called the Venice of India.
The Venice of the East.
The Venice of the East.
Udaipur is a really nice place.
It's beautiful. So that is what we painted out there. Mm-hmm. That was the thought behind. So
some clients are nice.
And Venice of the East, what did you paint in the Venice of the East?
So once you get there, you get an idea why it's called. It's quite very, it's very beautiful. So I wasn't expecting that. So actually the client said whatever you feel like, because he gave us the full freedom. So we actually fused both India, like Udaipur and the Venice. So we created one element out of it. So that's what we did in Udaipur.
Okay.
It's so nice.
But do you ever meet your friends and relatives or anyone, parents, and do they ask you, what is all this? What are you doing?
Yeah, because art is quite forgotten now. Because,
not everyone values it.
Why do you say that?
As far as money is concerned, so artist, I don't think it makes a lot of money.
But it's a huge problem.
Huge.
What do your parents say? Oh, art doesn't make any money.
Not just parents, like everybody.
Yes, everyone.
And so it's your passion that's keeping you going for it.
It's keeping us happy, so that's why.
Because we are working all together, friends all together, going here and there.
We travel together.
Work together, and travel together. And art has made you travel to many places. Have you been outside India? Have you been somewhere in the South Asian countries? Have you been to Southeast, South Asia?
Not yet. We got an offer from Middle East though.
Okay.
So, but to be honest, we don't have passports right now.
So the first thing you artists need more than anything else are passports, right? And so I was asking you about the concept of street art, right? And how is it different? Do you think that it is evolving here? Is it
in
acceptable
India, yes.
now?
Yes, it's
growing.
It is growing, yes. Okay. And why do you say it's growing?
There's something cool on their wall. So once you get to Shapurjad, when this festival was happening, they don't know this word called graffiti. The local people were calling it tattoo. Can you make a tattoo at my place? So it is appealing to them as well. So it is attracting them as well. So it's quite new for people's eyes right now.
So what is graffiti according to you guys? What is graffiti? Is it different from street art?
That Ajitesh will tell, one of our members.
Why don't we call on Ajitesh? Please join us.
Oh, yeah.
Please join in, Ajitesh.
Hi.
Hi. Welcome to Beyond. We are talking to you guys live from New Delhi on street art culture in New Delhi. And Ajitesh, why don't you tell us what's the difference between graffiti and a street art?
See, graffiti is an Italian term. It means drawing, literally.
Okay.
Like drawing is called graffiti in Italian. So basically the trend, that word meant drawing, but gradually, as the cultures mingled up, like the Italian immigrants went to US, and the graffiti culture started from the US, right?
Exactly.
The basic first purpose was for propaganda stuff, like the Viet War happened and this and that. And gradually it took form of vandalism. And gradually it became a form of art. So graffiti, urban art, street art, that's all the same thing. But if someone is commissioning you a commercial piece to go with his interior decor or something, that's called a mural. But at the end, it's all the same thing.
So you guys do murals. Can you explain to our viewers what are murals exactly?
Supposedly, like if a client wants a particular piece on their wall, suppose they want a Buddha figure painted on their wall, that's called a mural because it goes with the architecture. It's not random.
Okay.
The people wanted it, like they commissioned. And urban art is like, there's no reason for it. Like, no one particular is asking for that. We want to do that. That's urban art. Like, and it's visible.
So murals are basically client-based, probably. What they want, we'll paint. And whereas this is concerned, that's our
street
choice.
Street art, that is...
Street art is a choice.
Yeah,
it's a choice. It's like painting on the canvas of the world.
Yeah, exactly.
Can you agree with that? It's like painting on the canvas of the world. But do you ever think that you want to come out of this canvas and paint on an actual canvas?
There's one quotation, I don't know who said it, but art should not be confined to frames.
Okay, art should not be confined to frames.
It's limiting, you know, like...
There's no boundary in street art.
Like, canvas is limited to its size. There's only a limit to where you can paint, and then you have to hang it or somewhere. But street art is like... So many cities are there, like, it's an endless canvas. You don't have to stop at this wall. It goes on, it goes on.
So would you say that people don't have the time to view art today?
Yeah, you can say that.
People, they don't really value it.
Are very busy to make money. They don't see the beauty of the world.
And like, in a way, they want it. But whereas money is concerned, they're restricted. Like, no.
Because money is all they want.
Yes.
Alright. So would you say that your paintings or your art form is bringing art to the people? Like, people are not going to the art. The art is coming to the people.
Sometimes you have to force feed things. So if they don't want to come and see, we'll push that out to them.
Pushing art onto people. That's brilliant. Creating a concept of art in India? Do you think it's more influenced by mythology? Is it more mythical as compared to in other countries where you have drawn superheroes?
Yeah.
But, I've seen wall art, street art in India where paintings of Shiva or Goddess
Durga. Because India
it's
people
both, I guess.
Worship lords and also to grab their attention, maybe people are trying to draw that on that.
Right. If you look on a larger scale, mostly foreign painters are painting that stuff. Yes. They are more fascinated by it.
Would you say that?
I would, yeah. They are more fascinated by it. They want to show us like how they interpret it. Because we have had enough of that stuff, you know, we have grown up watching, seeing those calendars and stuff. So it's not something we would like to draw spontaneously until someone tells us, right? You don't just draw a random Shiva on a wall. Unless someone asks or if that place is religious or whatever. But mostly foreigners do that, like foreign artists from Germany, US. They want that kind of stuff. We went to Manali, Pushkar. Most of the religious artworks there are done by
foreigners. Also, would you tell us the difference between the art here and art over there? If they like painting Shiva, then what do you guys like painting the most? Is it just a difference in cultures from various countries?
You could say that.
There's a
difference in cultures from various countries.
Yeah, and your own choice
also.
Okay.
Everyone likes trying new things, you know.
People like trying new things.
Yeah, because most of the things that we have in India are one way or the other influenced by the West. Like, we draw superheroes.
Right.
And most of them are not Indian. Mm-hmm. Right? We had those influences. In the same way, they had those influences.
The Indian. Like, they're attracted to religious stuff.
Okay. So you also said in the conversation that you don't want to limit yourself to a canvas, right? So which is the biggest wall art that you have drawn or street art that you have done on a particular wall? And tell us.
We have done that in Agra. We draw a two-story Taj Mahal.
Agra?
Yeah, okay. Agra.
So Agra is one of the most famous tourist destinations in India, and millions and millions of people come to see the famous Taj Mahal.
Yeah, exactly.
Where exactly did you do this street art?
So there's this hostel called Zostel.
Zostel.
Yes.
Yeah. So on the exterior, it's a two-story Taj Mahal we draw.
Alright.
We painted.
Okay.
It's quite big. Okay. It is the biggest artwork we have done.
How big is it? Like, can you tell us the measurements?
20-25 feet long.
Okay.
And then you 15 feet broad. Yeah.
How much time did it take you guys to make that?
3 days, I guess. Yeah,
3 days.
Yeah, 3 days.
So when you go for 3 days, you draw continuously or you take breaks in
No,
between?
We take breaks.
Of course.
Okay.
We majorly work at night. So that's our time.
You work in the night?
Yeah.
In the darkness?
Yeah.
How do you draw so well, like so refined? There are elements in your drawings that are really refined.
Like we have good lighting as well. But
do you use really good lighting?
Yeah, we do.
Okay, so there's a question here, our viewers asking us, why do young people don't prefer it as a financial career? Why don't young people like yourself want art or street art to be taken up as a financial career? I mean, you could give them valid points because I want to let our viewers know that these wonderful people are actually taking their street art and making it commercially viable. They are paid for projects across India to work on commissioned art by clients. So why don't you tell us more about that?
So that is what I said before, that people don't really value it. Like they even want it, but whereas this money is concerned, they don't really want to give us. So that is why probably people don't take it as commercially, like as a financial career.
Because people want to have the artwork on their walls at home. But in India, it's now for just they want to show off that we have a beautiful wall at our place.
Okay.
It's not about admiring the art. Because
okay.
people, when we do stuff, we paint, then people come to other people and then they tell that I can also do that. I used to do that, but I left it for job and all.
So how do you feel when people come and say I can also do this?
We just ignore.
Yeah.
Okay. There's a viewer saying hi. Hi, back to you.
Hi.
Hi.
And these guys are telling us why they want to paint. Do you all visit schools where you could spot young kids with talent? Do you visit art schools to kind of join more members in your team? Do you want more hands in your team? There's a viewer asking us this question.
Not till now, we...
Yeah, we do need them, but we have to, it takes a bit time to be commercially sustainable.
Okay.
We are a team of 6 people and sometimes it's very hard for us because there's a very little return in it. Like it's the path less traveled anyways, so you won't find much crowd in art.
Do you take interns as well? Do you take interns?
Not yet.
Yeah,
not
as
yet.
You
could take free interns. They could paint with you and just for the experience.
We've been thinking about it.
Okay.
It's just in process.
Yeah, but thinking about it.
But so how long does it take for you to get a commissioned art project in your hand? Like, is it something that comes to you every month, every week, every month, every 2 months?
It's very uncertain.
Yeah, very random.
Very random, actually.
Okay, so our viewers asked us, how far does art need to go to be taken from a hobby to a career?
It's growing, it's in process, it'll take some time.
Like, it's just one day when you realize that this is what you love doing and you want to do this in the rest of your life. And then it doesn't matter if the money is coming or not.
Yes.
It's all about you, what you feel.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's about your passion.
Exactly. It's all about passion. It's all about the love. And speaking of love, thank you for so many likes, dear viewers. And you could ask us more questions. You could ask the team Baldy a few more questions about their art and how they make it sustainable. What's your dream project? Can you tell us about a dream project that you would want to be in?
Yep. For that, I would like to call the next member of our team.
Oh, sure. Please.
Yeah. Palak.
Please, Palak, join us in our conversation about street art.
Hi, I'm Palak.
Okay, hi Palak. There's a viewer asking us, when you were younger, did you face reluctance? I mean, did your parents stop you from pursuing art as a student?
Well, yes, to some extent.
Yeah.
I was a science student. And though my mom herself, she's done her graduation in fine arts, she didn't want me to pursue this thing as a career.
Why is that?
Yeah, because she wasn't aware about the opportunities ahead. Because I am the eldest one, so they weren't aware. Okay. But I took a stand that no, I just want to do this. No. That's what I want to do in my life. Then they gradually understood my passion and they supported me totally. They still support me with it. They're very happy with whatever I'm doing. And now they're happy.
Now they're happy.
Yeah, they're very well happy.
They see a career option for you.
Yeah.
So taking from that, you know, another a viewer was asking us, why is it that it takes long for people to pursue art as a
Because people aren't aware about the opportunities right now. You know? They know that, you know, getting jobs in art, they're not very well aware about it.
So it's that's still the reason. Growing, that's yeah. what I said.
Now, okay, it's actually growing. You know, people are now actually taking up art. So that ratio is increasing gradually.
All right. So the viewers also asking us, where do you see yourself a few years from now?
Maybe a big company, worldwide famous.
Then we can take interns.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Okay.
Paid.
So,
paid.
So when you'll be a big company, where would your dream project be? I was asking you about your dream project earlier.
We are going with the flow right now. So, it depends on the situation and the opportunities we get.
But you must have had a, when you started off, you know, you might have had a dream saying, I want to paint this or I want to do this. I want to paint, you know, some big city.
When we started, we never thought we'd reach this far.
There was no planning, there was nothing.
Yeah. Okay. That was just this random wall near our college, you know, doing everything at the weekend and just listening to people and their views on the weekdays because they didn't know who we were.
Okay.
So, and the first totally project anonymous. We got was from Hyatt.
We did an event there,
yes.
So it was a Halloween Hyatt, party there.
Hyatt Hotel.
Yes, Hyatt Hotel. Okay. Yeah. So we did the music, we did the decor for the whole party, and we decided the games and everything. So we made huge canvases for the decor.
Do you think that artists abroad or internationally are more respected than artists are respected in India?
Yes,
I would
say
that.
To some extent, yes. Art is actually valued, you know. There's a whole definition, different definition of art outside India. Right. India, people are still getting the hang of it. Yes. Still, like I told you, the ratio is increasing, but yes, now people are realizing the value. Still, there's a lot of people, you know, who would, you know, in my family also, they'll be like, oh, what are you doing and everything. But there's some also like that, you know, whoa, you're doing like good work or something. So we've got mixed people.
Mixed
India
opinions.
Is a mixed.
India is mixed, huh?
Yeah, diverse.
Okay, so our viewers also asking us, Zafar Abbas Zedi. Thank you so much, Zafar, for your entertaining questions. Have you ever left an autograph on your pictures or wall art? Do you autograph it with your name or?
Yeah, we do these amounts.
We do that. So it's called tagging in street art language. It's called tagging. You tag it as your name or do you tag it as Waldi?
We tag it as Waldi.
As Waldi. Okay. And thank you viewers for your likes and comments. And thank you so much for those who are joining in. We are talking to Waldi, the coolest street art makers in New Delhi, who have taken their passions forward and created street art all across India. They've done it in Agra, they've done it in Udaipur,
Goa,
Jaipur. And Pushkar as well. Jaipur as well. So you've done Udaipur, Jaipur and Pushkar, three cities in Rajasthan.
Yeah.
Is Rajasthan the cool, hip place?
It's like more of a tourist place, so more hostels, more backpackers. So,
okay, namaste to you, 777-785, who has joined us live on Periscope. And we'd also like to show you a live artwork that's currently happening right here. And Sultan is at work. So we'll pan the camera and you'll see these visuals. So look at that. So Sultan is doing something for us here. Sultan, can you tell us what you are drawing?
Just one random hipster along with the news channel's logo.
So I'm almost done. So I'll just, I'm on the outline procedure right now.
So hi viewer, this is happening in New Delhi. This is New Delhi, India. And Sultan is drawing doing a live street art for us on the wall. This is happening in East Delhi.
Yeah.
East Delhi. And look at the way he's trying to create definition in the art. What is the concept of this hipster? Like, can you tell us something?
I just wanted to make something cool. Then, even if I grow old, I want to be as happy as him. So I can't work in an office. Go have a daily routine kind of life.
So do you guys think that people can't work in offices? Artists can't work in offices?
Yeah, it's kind of bounds your emotions and you kind of bounds you.
We need a cool atmosphere in the office.
Yeah.
Okay, we need a cool atmosphere in the office.
Yeah.
A viewer is telling us he loves the way that you are so defined on the matter that you're drawing
here.
And just look at the... Who's the inspiration behind this hipster?
I just randomly thought, like, what if I grow old? Would I be like, would I lose my?
Would I be blue-haired?
No, I mean, would I lose my childhoodness? I'm not coming up with a word. So
youth.
Yeah, my youth.
Do you want to say youth?
Yeah, grammar police.
And a viewer says, you know, artists need breathing space. Do you agree with that?
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Breathing space. Yeah.
Like what kind of breathing space? You want to go to the mountains and paint, or you want to think?
Like
you want to travel and you want to do our stuff as well.
Oxygen.
Yeah.
And no nagging.
Exactly.
So our viewer is asking us, what would you like to tell the Prime Minister of the country for budding artists in India?
Hello,
art
Modi.
And art culture.
For more opportunities and for people to actually value it.
There shouldn't be any other kids losing out on hope that they want to be something, they want to do something.
So that people can actually take it as a career option freely. And not just
kill their dreams just because their parents are not supporting.
And how would you want, should universities or art schools create such kind of ways for students to take up their passions and not worry about other things?
Yeah, yes. There should be some counseling or something which can at least make the parents aware about, you know, there are quite a lot of options after doing art. Even if you take it professionally, these guys have like cinematographers and everything.
You can do everything in art.
Yeah, it's like a very vast thing.
There should be a support from everywhere, I would say. And especially from the family.
Yeah. Parents should really encourage their kids, you know.
Yeah.
Go take up art. Even if they want, because there are kids who are just killing their dreams because their parents are not supporting them.
Yes, this mural is happening on the streets of Delhi. The mural, the artwork that is being drawn here is on the streets of Delhi. And so they are all street artists. That is their forte. We let you look at the visuals for a bit. Thank you, viewers. Thank you for the likes and the wonderful, wonderful questions that you've been sending in for our artists. So there's a very interesting question a viewer is asking us, if Palak or Rashika would like to answer that. How do you feel when you meet your other friends who are like doctors or engineers, and you know, they are like, oh, we are doctors and engineers.
some of them really like what we do, you know, and they're like fascinated with, oh my god, you really did that. And some of them are like, oh, I was still doing painting and stuff, you know. They don't understand the concept of art.
Not really everyone gets it.
Yeah. Okay. Though the ratio in my group and my friend circle, those who are fascinated with the work I do are more.
So it's a matter of choice, I would say.
The people who understand art actually, you know, like such things. Wow, you could really good stuff and something like that.
Okay, so yes, Vijayata, all of these are artists and they have their own art startup. It's called Wall B. They make street art and they also get commissioned to make street art. So yes, they are making a viable career out of their passion. So what is the best compliment that you have received? Another viewer is asking us.
See, we used to paint on our college walls. Like, there's a Maggie Point. There's a Maggie Point in our college. So the best thing is, when we used to paint, it was on the weekend. So the next day, when you go on the weekdays, you see people standing in front of our artwork. So you know that you have done it, but they don't know, and they're calling their friends. Oh, see, something cool is happening in our college.
And they're clicking pictures. Like that.
Okay, hi Fatima. So there's a viewer, Vijayata, is saying, can she join you guys for such projects?
Sure.
I know. And she seems really keen and interested in joining you guys for these projects.
Sure, but right now it'll be free. Free interning.
Sorry about that.
Yeah.
Alright, yes, I'll just write yes. World in One News.
Yes, absolutely. This is Beyond WION. World is One News, where we bring you the latest and coolest updates from across Delhi and across the world. That's really nice, Vijayata. Vijayata has also done some artwork in Cosmos.
Oh wow,
that's great.
So I think she's really, really interested in joining you guys. So we'll put in some details. You can chase them.
Yeah, you can find us on Facebook and Instagram as well.
Yeah.
By wall.b.street.
So please contact us.
Yeah.
You can follow them on Facebook and Instagram. Their Facebook is called WallB. The same name in the... You can follow their Facebook. Can you draw Beyond for you?
Yes.
Oh, he's just writing the name. That's that's an expression of the artist. Lovely hearing all your questions. Yes, the world is definitely one, and Sultan is getting compliments for his calligraphy. Thank you so much, Vijayata. Thank you so much, Zafar. So Thank you, viewers. Zafar, thank you so much for your comments, and you've been very interactive with us. Come, what do you think about his art? Just tell us something. About the old Dipti here. So that's the complete art form. We just show you from behind, like we show you the full thing. Show you the full thing here. What's your individual perspective on this?
You still want to be cool when you're old enough. Okay. But
Zees and World is One News is not an old company. Okay, we're all young and we're all millennials and we're looking forward to working with them.
So we hope it grows old like this, cool enough.
Okay, and thank you so much, viewers, for being so interactive with us. This is World is One News, and Waldi, the team of Waldi, is right here with us. And thank you for being so kind to answer our questions and answer our viewers as well.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you for watching, viewers.
Thank you for watching. We'll join you again tomorrow. This is World in One News. Thanks, guys.